Hello, welcome back to the Boardgames 4K YouTube channel, and this is a channel where we give you reviews, playthroughs, unboxings, and we generally talk a lot of bollocks about tabletop gaming in general. And in this video, we're going to be talking about a hidden traitor social deduction game called The Resistance. So in this game, you'll be assigned a hidden role. You'll be going on missions to try and unearth the traitor or not that will allow you to win the game. We'll be giving you a very brief overview of the rules. We'll be telling you what we do like, what we don't like, and then we will come back and we'll tell you whether or not the Resistance is still worth playing today and in the future. So if you're new here, then please consider subscribing to this channel. Leave a comment in that section down below, and we'll see you after this. Boardgames 4K. So, The Resistance, how do you play this game? So, The Resistance takes place over two phases, and the first phase is where you will be building the teams that will be going out onto these missions, right? So at the beginning of the game, everyone will decide to assign a leader, and the leader will then choose a number of people that are going to go on the missions dictated by what's on the mission cards. And the leader will throw these tokens at these different people, and then everybody will vote yes or no as to whether or not they agree these people should go on these missions. If the teams are approved, then you move on to the next step. If the teams are rejected, then the leader will pass the leader token clockwise and you will go again until the teams are approved. So then you'll go on to actually conducting the mission, and what you'll do, everybody's got a pass or a fail card, and then the people that have been selected to go on this mission will then choose to pass the mission or they will choose to fail the mission. If you are a member of the Resistance, then you have to choose pass, but if you're a member of the corporation, then you can choose pass or fail. And then everybody will hand in the cards that they've chosen. The leader will shuffle the cards under the table, then they'll reveal the cards, and if there's even one fail in that deck, then the Resistance will lose and you'll mark the failure or the pass on the mission card. So once you've done that, then the leader will pass the leader token clockwise and you will go again until you've gone all the way through all the different missions that are on the mission card. And at the end of the game, if the Resistance has the most successes, they will win, and if the corporation has the most successes, they will win. Right, so that's basically how you play the Resistance. So what do we like about the Resistance? So the first thing that we really, really like about this game is the amount of banter that is chucked across the table when you're playing this game. And not only do you get to argue about who the spy is, but you also get to argue about who's going on a mission. So there's two levels, there's two layers of accusations going on here. You've got the teams and the actual mission itself. And we really, really like the way that it's really, really difficult at the beginning of the game to sort of, you know, figure out who is the spy and who's not. And obviously this game played in isolation can just be a case of just running through the missions. But if you're playing this in an evening, then you're going to be playing this, say, 3, 4, 5 times, right? And when you do that, a little metagame emerges, like a lot of these hidden traitor games, and you'll find that you'll sort of be judging your actions, your accusations, based on previous games, and people start getting into character. You start second guessing people that were maybe sort of your allies in the last game, and then thinking, well, if they did that last game, are they going to do this game? And we really like that sort of meta game that emerges from the Resistance. So the second thing that we really like about the Resistance is the game length, and this sort of condenses down games like Shadows over Camelot and even longer games like Battlestar Galactica into a length that is probably about a quarter of the time. So you can burn through a mission in, say, a quarter of an hour, maybe 20 minutes, whereas Shadows over Camelot might take you an hour and a half, 2 hours to get through that one. So you can get the same kind of buzz out of this one as you can do with those proper sort of board games, yeah? So the third thing that we really like about this is the theming. The dystopian corporate sort of 1984 type vibe going on here is absolutely perfect for this type of game. And there's definitely this sort of sense of this sort of Strange Days, sort of Orwellian type thing going on here. And whilst the artwork isn't absolutely fantastic, it's actually sort of quite crap, I think. But yeah, I think they've updated this is it a third edition or something? But yeah, the theming is absolutely perfect. And I don't think, even though they've done the Arthurian style Resistance, it might be the better game with the added couple of characters, but the theme for us is much better. This sort of modern or postmodern theme is much better. So what don't we like about the resistance. So the first thing that we don't like about the resistance, probably the main thing that we don't like about it, is it's so bloody hard for the resistance to succeed at this game. And we've played this a gazillion times, and probably, you know, 2/3 of the time that we've played this, the resistance has failed, yeah? And it's very, very difficult to knuckle down on a sort of a strategy, because where the teams morph all the time, you can't really sort of come together and formulate a strategy on this one, and it's really difficult. But on the flip side of that, if the resistance actually do win this one, then the whole house erupts. So yeah, it's a bit of a double-edged sword, that one. So the second thing that we don't like about the resistance, and this goes back to when we first found this game, when we first played it, we read on the back, you know, you're going on missions or whatever. What's it say on the back here? The resistance has launched a series of daring missions to bring the government to its knees, right? So we thought, oh, you know, we're going to be going on mission, we're going to be pointing the finger. But when you actually crack the box open, when you actually go on these missions, you realise that there's no missions at all. It's just nothing. You know, you're just moving this little counter along this track, and there's not actually any sort of substance to the missions at all. And that was a little bit disappointing. I know, obviously, that's nothing to do with the game, but our expectations were sort of let down a little bit when we first played this game. But we've subsequently got over that, and we've taken this game for what it is, a sort of a light-hearted social deduction game that can be played with larger groups. So the third thing that we don't like about this game is the fact that there are no characters and there's no special abilities, and we think this game would have benefited from maybe sort of chucking in some sort of nice characterizations or some extra game breaking special abilities. And I know that this was addressed in the previous iteration of this, the Arthurian one, I can't remember what it's called now, Resistance Avalon, that's it. This was addressed, and it probably is the better game, but we would have preferred it if the same concept had been sort of melted in to this one, because we prefer the theme at the end of the day. And we have got the, what's it called, the Hidden Agenda or something expansion that was on Kickstarter, but it's been stuck on the shelf for 4 years and we haven't bothered playing it because we don't like to add any complexity. But a couple of characterizations might have been nice in this game, right? So to summarize, is the Resistance still worth playing today and in the future? So we're going to say yes, this is the seminal Hidden Traitor social deduction game that should be in everybody's collection. This changed the face of gaming for us. This was a complete eye-opener. We were blown away by this game way back in the day when we first got this. And it subsequently nailed itself down to be one of the go-to Hidden Traitor games that you can get. And the fact that it takes the sort of Dead of Winter, Battlestar Galactica, Shadows Over Camelot, Hidden Traitor elements and condenses it down into a manageable, bite-sized experience is second to none. So we're going to give this 5 stars. Okay, outdated a little bit, but it doesn't matter because I don't think it's actually been surpassed. You might disagree with that. If you have got any ideas about which games have replaced the Resistance, then just stick a comment down below, because I'd be really interested to find out. But we're going to give this 5 stars. It's one of our favourite games of all time, and that is the Resistance. Remember, if you're new here, then please consider subscribing to this channel. Leave a comment in that section down below, and we'll see you next time. We'll be right back.